Now, when you're bringing up millions of dollars in ridiculous purchases, you can't forget Antoine Griezmann. I mean, come on. In 2019, this dude literally signed a $145 million deal. And he couldn't just be the average soccer player and cop a Ferrari. Nah, this man had to be exclusive. So he went out and spent $500,000 on this. Antoine caught one of the iciest and rarest watches in the entire world, a Rolex Rainbow Daytona. This masterpiece came with a 36 baguette cut rainbow sapphire bezel and 56 brilliant cut diamond watch. At least it's something Antoine could show off. Mario Balotelli though, he spent $1 million committing crimes he knew he'd get caught for. Yeah. See, it all started when Mario signed with Man City on a $31 million deal. And for a player as wild as him, that was just too much money in his bank account. So he had to cash out. And with that, Mario splurged on a $180,000 Maserati and a $250,000 Bentley Continental GT. And there was a reason he got it camoed out. Just wait on it. But the cars themselves weren't the stupidly expensive problem. It's what he did with them. See, at first, Mario was a normal, law-abiding citizen, following the speed limits and parking in designated spots. But eventually, his millions of dollars turned him into a monster. See, Mario came to this odd realization that he was a celebrity soccer player. Nobody could tell him what to do, not even the police. So when Mario would pull up in his Bentley or Maserati to restaurants or your mom's house, instead of being respectful, he'd just drive up and park wherever the hell he felt like it. All over the lines, on the curb, at the front door. Dude would drive right into the building if he could. And hey, this dude's 6'3", 220. Are you telling him he can't do that? I ain't think so. Now, you want to know his reasoning for doing this? He was tired of walking to his car. I feel your pain, man. That 20-foot walk in the parking lot, it's brutal. But see, the police, they didn't care who he was or what he was worth. All they saw was a maniac breaking the law. So every single time he'd park like this, they'd give him a ticket. And at one point, Mario was averaging 3 parking tickets per day. And you wanna know what's crazier than that? His fines racked up $500,000. And Mario didn't learn any lessons from this. So he kept doing it. And it led to his cars being impounded 27 times. That's gotta be a record, holy sh**. But okay, eventually he was tired of having to pick up his car after every meal, so enough was enough. One day, Mario decided the car was the problem, so he gave it away to his teammate. Pfft, my friends can't even pick me up from my house and I live a block away. Dude's just giving his friends his cars. Now, spending $1 million just to break the law, that's one thing. But Neymar, he cashed out because he was bullied into it. See, for Neymar, it wasn't always Ferraris and rainbows. And trust me, if anybody could afford a rainbow, it's him. But for real, it was his tragic childhood that caused an $80,000 purchase. See, when Neymar was a kid, he grew up in the worst conditions imaginable. Like, I'm talking his family was so poor. They lived in a house with no food, no electricity, in an area that people threw away their garbage. And if that wasn't hard enough, when Neymar played soccer in the streets, every single day, neighborhood kids bullied him. They'd make fun of Neymar's hand-me-down clothes and teeth that his family just couldn't afford to be better. But Neymar didn't let it bring him down. It only fueled him to make a way out for him and his family. So he sacrificed everything and dedicated his entire life to become one of the greatest soccer players his country's ever seen. And in 2009, Neymar did it. He proved to every one of those kids that with a smile like his, it didn't matter, because he started signing $100 million deals and went from the ghetto of Sao Paulo to mansions in Rio. And just to rub it in those bullies' faces, right after he signed his first big contract, he copped a $2,500 per tooth, $80,000 smile that lights up any picture they see of him. Just look at Neymar, man. So inspirational. Now what's crazy is, Neymar didn't only spend stupid money because of his haters. In 2019, he spent over $14 million because of Batman. Yeah, just bear with me. See, Neymar isn't like us normal people. He can't just buy a car or some clothes and call it a day. Nah, man, come on. It's Neymar. He's gotta go all out. And that's why he splurged over 14 mil on this. Damn, man. And I thought I was high. Neymar ain't playing. He couldn't just show up to training camp in a Rari or a Wraith. Dude had to fly in like a movie. And listen to this. His Mercedes-Benz helicopter can have 10 passengers. And would it really be Neymar's without his logo on the tail? And yeah, I know what you're thinking. What the hell does any of this have to do with Batman? Well, dude literally had the entire inside customized to match his favorite superhero. Man, this dude's got a weird obsession with the way he blows his money, but hey, at least he doesn't have a spending addiction that's deadly. Yeah. See, back in 2019, Jerome Boateng decided that his Bentleys and Mercedes just weren't drawing enough attention. So he needed to blow his money another way. And well, most people who finally get millions of dollars, they'd invest or at least cop a mansion. But Jerome, he's built different. He needed something that was gonna freeze him to death. And he knew just the guy for the job. He pulled his phone out, called up Gabriel the jeweler, and well, damn, dude's about to be out here looking like the fourth Migo. Jerome went out and copped some of the iciest, coldest jewelry I've ever seen. A custom $100,000 Audemars Piguets with a diamond bezel and 30 karat stones. Three Cuban link chains, all flooded in VVS diamonds. And last but not least, Gabriel threw our boy a birthday present. Just because he dropped a like and subscribed to the channel. Yeah, I'm trying to get you iced out like this. So what are you doing? Click it. But anyways, Gabriel gave our boy a massive $200,000 white gold link chain covered in 110 carat diamonds. Man, and I didn't even get a card for my B-Day. Dude's out here getting houses to wear around his neck. What? Now listen, man. $500,000 shopping sprees, that's cool and all. But imagine spending thousands every time you're at your barber. Only David Beckham, man. See, as legendary as he was on the field, the dude became more known for his looks than he did for his soccer records. Ridiculous. But that did mean endorsements were being thrown at him from every direction. And one of those was Brill Cream. At the time, they wanted to promote their hair cream as a product for sleek, sporty, and smart personas. And they felt Beckham was the perfect man for the job, but under one condition. They needed him to get a very specific haircut. So specific that it would cost him $6,000. And to be honest, it doesn't look like anything my barber can't do for 30 bucks. But what do I know, man? I'm just a white boy with a fade. Now, Beckham thought long and hard about this. I mean, after all, it was more than just hair to him. It was who he was. But his wife saw the deal that Brill Cream was offering and forced him to do it. But see, it's all good. It paid off. Literally. Because Beckham ended up signing with the company on a 4-year, $6 million deal. So that one-time $6,000 investment was worth it. But see, 6K to a player like Cristiano Ronaldo? It's nothing. This man has some of the craziest purchases of any athlete ever. And in 2018, he put his money where his mouth was. Literally. See, for Ronaldo and his girl, it was date night. So they decided to hit up Scott's, one of the most flashy restaurants in all of London. And if you know anything about Ronaldo, it's that he's a billionaire pro athlete. He's trying to spend big. But when he was scanning the menu, as pricey as everything was, nothing for him was expensive enough. Luckily though, the waitress was a big Ronaldo fan. So when she came around to take his order and saw that he was pissed, she knew exactly what to do. She handed him a secret menu. Now, he took a few minutes to check it out, but he started seeing things that cost $10,000, so he knew he was in the right place. And Ronaldo went with a special wine that only he could afford. And I'm talking, it's so exclusive, I can't even pronounce this. But listen, it cost him $25,000. And man, I would have been good with a $30 Grey Goose. This man out here doing that? I need to party with this man. Now, as expensive as this wine was, they definitely didn't make it last. Because within minutes, it was already gone. But come on now, you know Ronaldo. This man makes $100,000 per day. So of course he copped another round. But this time, he wanted to conserve a little bit of money, you know, yeah, 25k, that's a little much, so he cheaped out. And this time, he went with a bottle of 1982 Bordeaux that cost him $13,000. Yeah, dude really spent $38,000 on two bottles. Two! Now, okay. $38,000 on wine, our boy's a billionaire. He can afford to do things that don't make sense. But one of his purchases became one of his career's biggest controversies. See, Ronaldo's known to flex his lifestyle to his 300 million Instagram and Twitter followers. I'm talking million-dollar cars, $10 million mansions. You never know what our boy Ronaldo might pull up with. But nothing compares to his $32 million masterpiece.
Attention passengers, you're now boarding Air Ronaldo.
Listen, this Gulfstream G200 jet can go 560 miles per hour, and it can fit 10 passengers. Ronaldo's plane even comes with Wi-Fi, an oven, microwave, and speakers to bump music. I just hope this dude lets me get the aux. I got bangers. Now, if something cost me $32 million, I'd definitely flex a picture of it. Anybody would, but especially Ronaldo. And he was just casually minding his business, posting a selfie of him on the plane. But it was the worst possible time he could have posted it. See, it was January 21st, 2019. And at the time, another soccer player named Emiliano Sala was on a flight from France to Wales. But his plane flew over the English Channel and disappeared. And right after the news broke that his flight went missing, Ronaldo posted his selfie. And even though Ronaldo didn't post this and mean any harm, the people on Twitter, his fans everywhere, even soccer legends, lost it and were calling him out, all because of a selfie that had nothing to do with the situation. Ridiculous. But listen, even a $32 million jet can't touch Ronaldo's secret purchase. And to be honest, I don't even know if I'm allowed to tell you about this one, but I just gotta do it. See, Ronaldo's known to be one of soccer's greatest players ever. Not only because he pushes the limits of his body, but he pushes the limits of technology too. And Ronaldo's curiosity led him to purchasing something that was never worn by any other player. A performance-enhancing mouthguard. Lately, Ronaldo's been rocking a mouthguard that actually improves his balance and increases his muscle power. This mouthpiece, it aligns his jaw perfectly with his skull and chest, and apparently, it helps distribute all of his energy throughout his entire body. And back in 2010, that's when Ronaldo started rocking this $130 piece. And ever since then, his game's been on another level. Just look at this. You cannot argue with the fact that this might be giving him superpowers. Now, it cost him $130. And I know what you're thinking, like, that's not a stupidly expensive purchase. But listen, Ronaldo's the most famous athlete in the entire world. And some of Steph Curry's mouthguards sold for $5,000, $7,000, and $25,000. So just imagine what a performance-enhancing piece would go for if it was game-worn by CR7. I already know one of y'all would probably pay $1 million for it. But speaking of millions of dollars, some soccer players have been cashing out. I'm talking they've been buying $10 million mansions that they can land a helicopter.